In Mantua, Romeo's man, Balthazar, brings him news from Verona. Juliet is dead. Her body sleeps in the Capulet tomb, and her soul is with the angels. Romeo is determined at once to leave for Verona. He does not know the real story because the friar's message has not reached him. He vows to take his own life with a poison and lie with his beloved Juliet that night. He seeks out an apothecary who will sell him a fast-acting poison illegally because he needs the money. Romeo pays the man and sets out for Verona, ready to die by the side of Juliet. Meanwhile, at his cell, Friar Lawrence learns that his letter has not been delivered to Romeo. Friar John, to whom the message had been entrusted, had become stuck in a quarantined house where plague was suspected. The letter would have told Romeo of the friar's plot, but now Friar Lawrence can only ask for a crowbar to break open the Capulet tomb. He's anxious that Juliet will awake from her drugged sleep and find no one there. He resolves to bring her to his cell and keep her there until Romeo can come. In the night, Paris comes to the graveyard to mourn Juliet's death. His page boy keeps watch and whistles to give warning of others approaching. Romeo and his servant Balthazar come near, carrying a torch and a crowbar. Paris hides. Romeo has written a letter to his father, old Montague, and gives this to Balthazar, telling him that now he wants to see his lady's face and take a ring from her finger. Balthazar must not stay and watch, or else Romeo will tear him joint from joint and strew his limbs about the churchyard. Balthazar, nevertheless, resolves to watch from a distance. Romeo starts to force open the tomb. Paris has seen what is happening and tries to stop him. Romeo tells Paris to be gone, but Paris provokes him and they fight. Romeo then slays Paris, who begs with his last breath to be laid next to Juliet. The page runs off to call the watch, and Romeo sorrowfully lays the body of Paris in the tomb. He gazes at the lifeless body of Juliet, kisses her, and lying by her side, drinks the deadly poison he has brought. He dies quickly. At this moment, Friar Lawrence approaches, stumbling through the graveyard, bringing a lantern, crowbar, and spade. He is met by Balthazar, who tells him that the light he sees in the Capulet tomb is Romeo's, and his master has been there for half an hour. Balthazar, after Romeo's threats, is afraid to go nearer, but Friar Lawrence approaches the tomb, seeing there are signs of bloodshed. Within, he sees Romeo's pale face and Paris's blood-stained body, both men dead. Juliet then awakes, asking for Romeo. Friar Lawrence, disturbed by noises outside, bids her come away quickly with him to be hidden in a convent. But Juliet, seeing Romeo dead, tries to kill herself with Romeo's poison. When she finds there is none left, she seizes his dagger in desperation and stabs herself. The officers of the watch arrive, and the old Capulets and Montagues gather at the scene. Friar Lawrence explains what has happened, supported by Romeo's letter to his father and by what others have seen. The old men resolve never to fight again, and the Prince of Verona declares, "Never was there a story of more woe than this of Juliet and her Romeo."